Hi, my name is Stephen Nguyen, and this is my last lecture. Chapter 1. An injured lion still wants to roar. I would consider my spirit animal to be a dog. Characteristics and qualities for a dog would exist of happiness, loving, curiosity, smart, shyness, and forgiveness. These characteristics help shape the person who I am today. I believe that I portray these characteristics because I am very loving and caring of my surroundings, including my friends and family. Furthermore, through the stress I get from school, I still manage myself to be happy as a person through family members and friends. From being described as a dog, I learn how to develop and grow as a person and care about the people surrounding me that makes me happy. Chapter 4. The Parent Lottery. I am truly grateful that I was born with a loving family that includes my father, mother, and sister. My parents helped shape the way I am today and how I act. My father is very strict and can be nice at certain times, but mostly strict because whenever I don't behave respectfully towards other family members or having bad grades, he would punish me in a bad way. From this, I tend to behave respectfully towards others and try my best at school. On the other hand, my mother is very caring and loving as she supports me through everything in life, whether I'm feeling good or times when I'm not. Chapter 7. I never made it to the NFL. As a teenage boy, my dream activity was to improve at the sport of basketball. Not only learning the skills and fundamentals in the game can help me improve, but I can utilize it as an everyday strategic when I encounter a problem in life. Throughout my whole childhood, playing basketball as a hobby shaped me into a very outgoing person and learned to never to give up. Chapter 11. The Happiest Place on Earth. My happiest place on earth will be Disneyland. The atmosphere and music at Disneyland brings me back memories as a little kid from watching television shows. Spending time with family members and making memories with them is the best moment. Happiness is the most important aspect in life because it can help you achieve many of your goals in life and you can have the ability to change other people's lives as well. From my happy place, I learned that happiness and joy is very important because with those two aspects, I tend to forget about the negative things in life. Overall, being happy can shape you into a better person as you would think positively and focus on yourself more rather than being down and negative. Life is worth living again. Oh, life is worth Chapter 21. Joy. Throughout my childhood and the present of my life, I've had someone that always helped me in life, whether it be moments of hard times or accomplishing tasks that I wouldn't be able to do by myself. Having a guardian angel is very important in life as they will help and protect you. My mom will be my guardian angel as she will always be there for me. She has always helped me through hard times when I'm sad or even happy. With my mom by my side, helping me through the things I needed help with, I learned many valuable and important life lessons. In life, you should never think that you can accomplish everything by yourself because there will always be a person that will give you a little help. Life is worth living again. Another day, life is worth living again. Chapter 24. A Recovering Jerk. In my life, I've had made bad decisions or mistakes that I regret making. Making mistakes is a huge part of life because I either live with it or I can't be forgiven. No matter what poor decision I make, I will always be punished by it. As a human, making bad decisions can make me into a better person and I can develop a better understanding of not making the same decision ever again. Moreover, learning from my mistakes is very important to me because every poor decision I make will eventually lead to good decisions in my life, due to me gaining a better knowledge of not making poor decisions in my life ever again. Chapter 28. Dream Big. In this time of life, many adults can influence the society, including children and myself, whether it be political, social, or religious comments. The population of adults are very apathetic of dreaming big because they have experienced many things in their life. To further elaborate, my visions of adults would be that some adults can have a pessimistic view of life, but on the other hand, few adults can be very influential and positive. One person that I would consider positive and influential would be my sophomore Spanish teacher, Ms. Reyes. Models of adults are very significant as each of them have different perspective on life. However, knowing both sides of adults can help you in life because they try to provide you the best information on life so you can succeed in your future. My spirit's at ease. I put my heart into your hands. Learn the lessons you teach. No matter. Chapter 53. Never give up. Throughout my life, I have had goals and dreams that I wanted to accomplish, but it didn't come easy for me since there were obstacles and challenges that were in my way towards reaching my goals. In my life, goals aren't effortless to reach because there would be hard times for me to reach my goals. However, I know that being determined and having perseverance will help me reach my goals. Also, important goals in life can be very hard to accomplish because you tend to forget that you even made a goal. However, goals can be very hard because every goal comes with obstacles and you need to overcome the challenges in order for you to reach your goals and desires. Chapter 56. Tigger or Eeyore? If I were to choose between Tigger or Eeyore, I would consider myself as Tigger, being optimistic about life rather than pessimistic. Prior to this, being optimistic in life provides much more opportunities for me rather than just giving up on them. In addition, being optimistic can help me motivate myself to overcome challenges I face in life and surpass my goals. I learned that being optimistic and positive are good traits to have because you will become a better person if you tend to demonstrate those traits to others around you. Overall, I would describe myself as Tigger because he is always positive about life no matter what the circumstances are. Chapter 61. The dreams will come to you. In my life, achieving my dreams is very important and overwhelming due to the fact that I want to accomplish the things that will lead to my dreams. However, it's not about how I manage to accomplish my dreams, but the decisions and choices I make in order to help me successfully reach my dreams. Also, it's very important that I make wise choices that will help me reach my goals instead of making poor decisions that can heavily impact my future. Reflections and thoughts. First of all, be happy. Surround yourself with positive people who will make you happy in life. Being down and negative will get you nowhere. Secondly, never give up. In life, there will always be hard times, whether it be about school or life in general. If you're aiming for your goals, never give up on those goals because you never know what goals you have for yourself can take you in life. Lastly, live life to the fullest. You only have one life and you should make it count. Do what makes you happy and don't let other people or opinions bring you down. I've never felt the feelings that I feel for you. So maybe we can make a way of me and you. I'ma treat you right tonight, let's make it last forever. I promise you that no one else will ever treat you better. And if you don't believe me, please see I don't need no effort. All you gotta do is flip that switch before we bed up.